Hello there, Ali here from Sports Simplets, and today I'm bringing you guys something a little bit different. I've been receiving a lot of emails from people asking me to go more into the esports domain, and I thought maybe I can test the waters with these console controllers. So I went ahead and made a PlayStation 4 DualShock controller and an Xbox One controller. So in this pack, you can get the front view of the PlayStation controller, the front view of the Xbox controller, the back view of the Xbox controller, and the back view of the PlayStation 4 controller. You can get them both as one pack, or you can get them separately. So I want to get started with the Xbox controller. I've been looking around and I found this Overwatch controller for the Mercy character. I thought it's a really cool design, so we'll try to replicate that in our template. So to get started, you can go to the editable parts folder here. I did create a library here to kind of help me make things go a little bit faster. First thing is we need to go and add our design in the add your design here. So double click on a smart object, and in this template I have some kind of a guide to help you place your designs and the exact same spot you want it. So if you turn on the markers, you can see if you put any graphics here, it's gonna show you where exactly it's gonna fall on the template. So I did look online and I found this Mercy wing logo. So first thing, I'm gonna try to mimic the placement of it on this controller. So let's try to do that. Right, seems about right. And then we just click Control J or Command J, then to duplicate this layer, then Control T. And if we right click on it and click flip horizontal, we get a mirror version of it that we can use on the other side. So right around here should be right. Let's push a little bit. Okay. Now we need to copy this grid enough. So if you click copy image, go back to Photoshop, Control V, we can have the image here so we can kind of copy the colors off of it. So if you double click here, we go to gradient, and let's pick the first color from here and let's pick the yellow from here. Let's make it a little bit more vibrant. Yeah, kind of like this. Okay, and then if we go here and we click copy layer style, click on the second layer and paste layer style, kind of copies the same, but here we can see that the gradient is inverted. So if we double click and we go to gradient, we just need to do something like this and it should work out. Alright, so now we don't need this image anymore, so delete it, and let's hide the markers and let's hide the grid, and let's close the smart object, click yes. Alright, so now what we need to do is to change the base color to white. Usually with these templates, I don't go for full white because this causes the template to lose some shadow details. So always go for something a little bit off-white, something like this. Alright, click OK. Here we have these extra couple of logos from Overwatch, so I already have prepared them here. So if I go back to the design here, turn on the grid and the guides and just drag it here. I can just size it and right about here. Let's hide the markers, the grid, save smart object. All right. Everything in this template is editable. So you can go in, for example, if you want to change the color of the buttons, we can do that. White or any kind of colors. You can even change the letters colors. But for this one, we're going to just leave it like it is. Just know that these two buttons are white, so let's do that. If we go to middle buttons, and first button, let's make it off-white. Second button, do the same thing. We can change the text colors if you want. But also, I'm gonna leave it like this. One last thing we can have fun with is the background color. So let's copy this yellow, or maybe like a little bit darker orange, something like this. And in the background, you can add like, for example, here, I prepared this Overwatch logo. Let me hide this background text. And yeah, something like this. That's pretty much it. So if you want to take a look at the quality of this template, you can go to 100% zoom and kind of take a look at the details and all these reflections and shadows. So for example, everything here, you can edit it, you can change it. So if you want more like a light, like a harsh lighting effect, you can just increase the lighting here, get more light. If you want to get more reflections, you can, for example, duplicate this layer to get stronger reflections. But overall, this is the level of detail you get with these templates. Now, moving on to the PlayStation controller. I'm a big Destiny fan, so I know no one plays this game anymore. It still has a place in my heart. So I would do like a Destiny controller. I like this one, but I feel we can do some changes to it. So I'm not gonna stick to it 100%. So let's see what we can do. So I looked online and I found this Destiny wallpaper. So I'm gonna use this as a base for my design. So if I go just go copy image, and let's get started with this one. Go to editable parts, open it up, then go all the way down to add your design here, double click and control V or paste, and here's our design. Let's turn on the guides and let's make this wallpaper a little bit bigger so it fits the whole design. I like how it kind of lines up with the home button. So push it a little bit down so it's perfectly matched with it. I'm a Titan fan, so I've already prepared this Titan logo from Destiny, which I'm gonna add on the right side of the controller. So drag it out here. Let's size it down a little bit. Try to fit over this, like kind of like this. It does have this extra gradient over it, so if we just put pin light, we'll just end up with dark pixels. So, all right, that's perfect. And I'm thinking about adding like a Destiny logo over here, so let's do that. All right. And I'm thinking about making this Destiny logo more like a gold tone. So, double click here, color overlay, and I'm gonna pick this gold color. Let's hide the guide and the grid, and let's save this smart object. One more thing is, I wanna do these symbols in the same gold we picked for the Destiny logo. So if you go to the symbols here, you just select the symbol. I'm gonna click the gold color here. Same for the square, circle, and the triangle. I also noticed that these arrows are still blue. So if you go to arrows around here, we can pick the same color or maybe a little bit darker. It's kind of like make him a little bit visible. Also, I have a text folder here where it has all the text that's on the controller. I'm gonna make everything gold, so I can just double click on the folder itself and color overlay, and it's already gonna pick this gold color. One last thing I want to do is add a Destiny logo on the touchpad here, so let's do that. All right, and let's make it the same off-white that we're using for the body. So something like this, maybe a little bit darker. Let's make it just a little bit smaller. I think it's a little bit too big. One last thing we can do is go to the background, and I like to pick some kind of a bluish gray color for the background. So let's pick a Destiny logo, put it on the background, and size it up. Let's make it white. And let's make it a little bit transparent, because I don't want it to be overwhelming the actual design itself. So something like this. And that's about it. Also, just to check out the details in this template, if you zoom in 100%, you can just see the level of details we have with these kind of templates and how everything is editable. So you can change every single piece in this template, buttons, texts, the pad, sticks, directional pads, everything. And that's about it when it comes to editing these controller mockups. I hope you guys like it. Please let me know if you want more esports stuff. We have stuff coming for soccer since this year is the World Cup. We also have some stuff coming with car wraps and a bunch of more interesting templates. So stay tuned. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube to stay in touch. See you guys soon.